Mall and you're stopping by for the first time. Thank you for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. Stick around a while by clicking that red button for more crafting on a budget, more everything on a budget videos to come. And if you click it again when the bell appears, YouTube should notify you every time I upload a new video, depending on the option that you choose in the drop-down menu of the bell. If you're interested in following me on social media, you can find those links, you guessed it, in the description box below. What have I got going on for you for today? Today, I am bringing to you a DIY that I am so stinking excited about because it is a DIY Dollar Tree farmhouse clock. Yes, I said a farmhouse clock. It is using just about 100% Dollar Tree items. Now, I will say the clock portion itself, the guts of the clock, are not from Dollar Tree, but it is something that you can get at Walmart for under $5. This is such a budget-friendly farmhouse clock, and it's one I think you're absolutely gonna love. So I'm gonna quit my gabbing, let's jump into it, and let's make a Dollar Tree farmhouse clock on a budget. I love this, I think you're gonna love it too. Let's get to it. Who is today's KB Creations Crafter of the Day? You'll wanna stick around to the end of the video to see if it's your creation that's being featured in today's video. For this DIY farmhouse clock, yep, you're gonna need 4 of these pallets. You can get these at Dollar Tree. These are by Crafter Square. Amazing, this is gonna be great. I'm gonna start off by removing the twine because we don't need twine for this clock. I know, right? I'm saying we don't need twine. Will I incorporate it or won't I? You'll have to stay tuned to see. I want to glue these pallets together, so to do that, I'm going to start off by using this crazy glue. This is a wood glue that you can find in the tools section, not the crafting section. This is the best wood glue ever. And on one side of the pallet, right here on each of the planks, I'm going to place some of the glue, and I'm going to start off by gluing my pallets together that way. Now, when I glue them together, I'm going to offset them. I'm not going to put them all in the same direction. If you want to, you can. I just thought that it would add a bit of character by offsetting them. Once I got the pallets glued together on the sides, I decided to go in with some of the jumbo popsicle sticks, and ask me why I'm using wire cutters to cut them in half. I'm guessing because I didn't want to use scissors, but I'm going to break them in half and I'm gonna glue them together where each of the pallets meet just to kind of add some stability to it. Yes, this is a power drill. We're gonna need that for this DIY. This power drill, you can find it at Walmart. It was $20. What's great about this is it's got a plug so you can recharge the battery. It doesn't have a battery pack that you take on and off. I'm gonna drill a hole right in the center of these pallets because guess what's gonna go there? Yep, the hands to the clock. Yeah, don't ask me what size drill bit that is because I have no clue. Honestly, I just got the biggest one out of my kit thinking that this would be a good size and that the guts of the clock would fit through it. Have I told you all that this succulent green by Folk Art that you can get at Michael's? Yep, it's my new favorite color. I love this green. I just feel like it is so farmhouse chic. I love it. And so yeah, all of these palettes are gonna get a nice good couple coats, good few coats of this Folk Art paint. So I'm gonna take a second to tell you why I use Waverly chalk paint so often. So many of you will ask me, what is the difference between a chalk paint and a regular Apple Barrel or Folk Art acrylic paint? The difference is the quality and paint. When you are using a Folk Art or an Apple Barrel paint, you can see as I'm applying it that it is watered down. It is a very thin paint. And so therefore, when you're using a thinner paint like that, it's gonna take more coats to get the coverage that you're trying to achieve. I have found when using a chalk paint, very seldom do I need more than one coat. And on the times that I do, a second coat really does do the trick, but 9 times out of 10, I really only need one coat of a chalk paint to get the coverage that I'm happy with. So therefore, I feel like you get what you pay for and the quality of paint kind of pays off. Dollar Tree has these amazing rub-on transfers. This is one of my favorite sets. It's got all these fun different words in it. And so I figured that these would be really fun to incorporate into this clock along with these letters. Now I'm not gonna add the letters, but I really like the vines and the greenery. And so with these, I'm gonna use a combination of both of them. I went ahead and cut all the words out that I was happy with, placed it on my palettes. And along with that, you can see that I am using the new Galvanized Numbers by Crafter Square. Love these. You're gonna need one set for these. I'm only gonna do the 12, 3, 6, and 9 because I feel like it's gonna take up too much room and the numbers are gonna be too prominent and dominant if I did all the numbers. And so that is why I'm just using the 12, 3, 6, and 9, and that way you only need one set of numbers, because once you start getting into the higher numbers, you're gonna need duplicate numbers, which means you're gonna have to buy more packs of the numbers. And so now that I've got it all set out, I'm gonna go ahead and just take the paper off of them. And again, these are a rub-on transfer. And so once I've got it in place, just by kind of rubbing over the plastic coating on top, you can then lift it up and the transfer slash sticker sticks to whatever surface it is that you're adhering it onto. Now, all of the letters that you do see on the surface of my clock are from both transfers. And I guess I did end up using the letters from the second set. I forgot that I put love and heart on there as well. Okay, seriously, how cool does this look? This was turning out better than I anticipated. To adhere the numbers onto the surface, I'm just using, some hot glue, because why not? We don't need to use anything else. If you want to, you can. Hot glue's gonna work. And this here, this is the clock kit that I'm using that you can find at Walmart in the craft section with the paints and the wood. This box here that comes in the kit, this is pretty much the guts behind what makes the clock work, what makes the hands move. It is powered by a battery. There is a bolt here on the front. You're gonna unscrew that because this is basically what's gonna hold this box onto whatever surface it is that you're trying to make a clock out of. So once you put the box, I guess, in the back, you're gonna go ahead and replace the bolt and you're gonna tighten it up good and tight, and that's gonna hold the mechanical part of the clock onto, our pallets. And just like that, we're already almost done. All we need to do now is add the hands. So you start off with the hour hand, you move on to the minute hand, then the second hand, and then there's a cap that just kind of goes on top that keeps them all in the place that they need to be in. And look at that, I've got a AA battery in the back once I flip this clock over. And look at how easy that was. We've got a ticking clock here. I love making clocks. I wanna make clocks for everybody. You know what, I think I might for Christmas, very easy to personalize, very budget friendly. There's a great gift idea, DIY clocks. Easy peasy. Now I will tell you, with this kit, the hands were kind of a brush gold and I thought about painting them, but I was a little bit worried about how it was gonna affect the way the hands moved, and so I didn't. Now I know that there are kits that have brush gold, bronze, oil rubbed bronze, black, and silver. And so it's best just to kind of get the kit in the color that you need ahead of time. On the back side, I am fresh out of sawtooth hangers. So guess what this is getting? One of my go-to twine hangers. This is gonna work perfectly. We're just really gonna pound it with a lot of hot glue so it doesn't fall. And we're gonna have a means to hang up our Dollar Tree farmhouse clock. Don't look at the backside. If you're gonna gift it, you're gonna wanna paint the backside, but this is for me and nobody's gonna see it. I know somebody's gonna say something, but I didn't wanna waste my paint. It took a lot of coats to get the coverage that I got. Who is today's KB Creations Crafter of the Day? It's going out to Holly, who's bringing to us her recreation of this Dollar Tree DIY Teacher Appreciation Gift. It's a budget-friendly one. Holly, thank you so much for sharing your creation with us today. I love this clock. I really, really do. I think it's quick, it's easy, it's budget-friendly, and I love the simplicity of it. I love the palette look of it. I just love everything about it. Now, this is a very versatile piece. It's one that can be done to suit in any decor style just by switching up the colors, maybe not using the palettes and using a solid wall decor plaque. You name it, it's easy. The possibilities are endless. Making a clock is simple, and I love the outcome of this one. So I say get creative, make yourself a clock. You're gonna love it because I love this one. I hope you all enjoyed today's Dollar Tree Farmhouse Clock DIY. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. And and let's get this video to 5,000 likes. Because like I always say, each and every one of your thumbs up and the comments that you do leave down below, they really do help my channel to grow, and it helps YouTube to notice me just a bit more. Until next time, everybody, I hope you have a fantastic day. Happy crafting on a budget. Stay happy, stay safe, stay healthy, but most of all,